Hello, 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 and welcome back to Delicious Kitchen. It's your girl, Dee. Thank you for joining me. Today on the menu are lobster tails. Yes. If you're wary like me about going out during these times, check out this video because I'm going to make a delicious date night dinner using lobster tails. Yes. Now, all you're going to need are some kitchen shears, a few lobster tails, medium, small, large, whatever lobster tails you can get your hands on, and you're going to need a little patience. Right there, I'm just trying to get my shear underneath the shell, and I'm not going too far, just right underneath that shell. You just want to cut going along the middle, and you're going to separate the meat from the shell. Very simple, very easy, but it looks like it takes a lot of time. It really doesn't. It just takes a little bit of patience. That's all. You're going to pull that meat away from the shell, and you're just going to take your time so you don't rip the meat and you don't damage the shell, because the shell is going to be used as a stool for your lobster meat to sit on. Mm-hmm. Yes, we're getting fancy around here. So right here, I'm just gently pulling the meat away from the shell without damaging the shell and without damaging the meat. So you just want to take your time. This is not a rush kind of thing. Just take your time, and the meat will separate from the shell really nicely and quite effortlessly. It doesn't really take that much of an effort. Just a little patience. And right there, you just want to slice it a little bit, because that's also going to help your seasoning to soak into your lobster tail. See how that's sitting beautifully? And you're just going to complete that same, those same steps for the next lobster tails. And then we're going to be ready to go. Right here, I'm going to show you how I did it again. I was trying to hold it up a little bit closer so that you can get a good view of exactly how I pull the meat away from the shell without damaging the shell or the lobster meat. And by the way, there are several different ways to make lobster tails. This is one of my favorite presentations because it reminds me of going to a fancy restaurant, but you're doing it at home. And since we're all kind of like stuck in the house anyway, you know, why not give yourself a little treat while you're at home? So once again, here you see me just taking my time to pull the meat away from the shell once again, as to not damage the meat. And then I'm just going to pull it gently, separate it from the shell. Of course, we're going to put the shell together at the bottom there. You can see you have to put the shell together at the bottom, and then you just sit that lobster meat right on top. And there you go.
Brown sugar, babe, I guess high up your love, I don't know how to be. Brown sugar, babe, I guess high up your love, I don't know how to be.
All right, as you can see, my lobster tail prep is complete, and right now I'm going to add some flavor. It's time for flavor. And I have a half a lemon, and I'm going to squeeze some fresh lemon juice on top of my lobster tails. I'm using my other hand there to catch the seeds. And by the way, you can use any seasoning of your choice. You don't want to overdo the seasoning on lobster tails because you actually want to get the lobster flavor. But right there, I'm just adding a little bit of fresh cracked sea salt. And right there, some black pepper. Of course, we got to go in with some garlic powder. in there. Brown sugar, babe. And paprika. Add a little bit of paprika for that color. Paprika adds beautiful color to any dish that you're making, most of the time at least. And we cannot forget the butter. Yes, butter. We're gonna add maybe about a tablespoon of butter to each lobster tail. Now, what would lobster tails or seafood for that matter be without a little bit of Old Bay? Yes, we gotta sprinkle on a little bit of that Old Bay seasoning. Ooh, a little Old Bay never hurt nobody. Okay, right here I'm just gonna give you a view, a 360 view of what my lobster tails are looking like before I place them into the broiler. And right here I have put them on my baking sheet with a little bit of parchment paper, and I decided to roast some broccoli alongside. And right there, I'm just adding a little bit of olive oil to my broccoli that I'm going to roast alongside the lobster tails. And I'm just going to lightly season my broccoli. Nothing major. Just going to lightly season them and put them in the broiler right along with the lobster tails. Some sea salt. We're keeping it real basic because we want that flavor from the lobster tail. A little bit of garlic. And a little bit of black pepper. Black pepper. There you go. All right, I'm going to put this in my oven on broil for about 20 to 25 minutes. And right here is the end result of my broil lobster tails along with some roasted broccoli. Looking pretty nice, looking pretty lovely. Once again, on broil, low, for about 20 to 25 minutes. And I don't cook my lobster or seafood really long because I don't want it to get chewy or rubbery. But if you want, you can cook yours a little bit longer, but I wouldn't suggest too much longer than that because it could start to get like dry and tough. Okay, right here I have it plated with some steak and a baked potatoes. This is how I presented it for my date night dinner. I'm probably gonna do a separate video on the steak and how I made the steak. If you enjoyed my video and you want to see more videos like this, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Until next time, bye.